Hey there, I wanted to talk to you today about using a drop-down box in an XLS, like an Excel spreadsheet that's downloaded onto your computer. So say if you're using Excel 2019, and you just have a spreadsheet that you've purchased from me, or you're using somewhere else and you're trying to figure out where the drop-down box is. So first of all, this column T does have drop-down boxes. You would have to click on the cell, and to the right of it, there's a little arrow, and then it'll show you all the items for the dropdowns, just like that. So the radon test, termite inspection, these all have dropdown boxes. If you scroll to the left, these also have dropdown boxes. Property status, contingency status, they have dropdown boxes as well. Let's go to another spreadsheet so you can look. This is my transaction coordinator's checklist, and again, if you're looking for the drop-down boxes, you click on the cell, and it's to the right of it with a little arrow down, and you click on it, and you can change that just like that. Another thing is, if you were looking for the actual checklist, like a checkbox in the XLS file, I do have that available for the pink transaction coordinator's checklist. And it is added to the listing in Etsy. But I just want to let you all know that it significantly slows down your Excel spreadsheet. So I have added the checkboxes in, but because I have 900 lines, every time that I've tried to use it or maneuver it, the thing just goes around in a circle. So I'm really just offering this in the Google Sheets at this time for the Excel download. So you really should use this on Google Sheets if you wanted to use it, because it just makes it all kind of simple and it slows it down. So another option that you could do, because I have added the XLS files to all of the downloads, so if you did purchase from me, they're all there. But they just don't have the checkboxes. So what you could do is, if you're in here, you could put a date as your method of this is when it was done, or you're welcome to simply do like a yes or no. And then that way you know if this was actually done. And that can be your method. So you can use either one, and I left it blank for you, but using the actual checkboxes for the actual download for 900 lines, and then I've got, you know, 8 or 9 different, multiple different items. You will just have to use a date or, you know, a yes or no option. So that is my 2 sheets. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out and send me a message. Thanks.